हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम मोनिका राणा, दिस इज जागो हिमाचल 365, डर के नहीं डट के, एंड यू वाचिंग हिलक्वेस्ट न्यूज़ चैनल। लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द हेडलाइंस। इंडिया सीज 60,753 न्यू कोविड केसेस, लोएस्ट इन 74 डेज। 23% डिक्लाइन इन रोड फैटेलिटीज इन हिमाचल प्रदेश। पीडब्ल्यूडी अंडर लेंस ओवर पुअर रोड क्वालिटी इन पालमपुर। लैंडस्लाइड डिस्टर्ब ट्रैफिक नियर सोलन इन हिमाचल प्रदेश। No power supply, oxygen plant non-functional in Palampur. Four lines at Chennai's Aregnar Anna Zoological Park found infected with Delta variant of COVID. Assam rocked by 4.2 magnitude earthquake, fifth tremor to hit region in 24 hours. Milkha Singh's story of struggle and strength will continue to inspire generations, said President Ramnath Kovind. Other leaders also condoled death of flying Sikh. Center likely to hold talks with Jammu and Kashmir parties on June 24. Congress seeks white paper as Swiss deposits touch 13-year high. Committed to free jobs for all, said Prime Minister Narendra Modi. Now news in detail. India says 60,753 new COVID cases, lowest in 74 days. With 60,753 new COVID cases being reported in a day, India's total tally rose to 2,98,23,546, while the number of active cases stand at 7,60,019, the lowest in 74 days, according to the Union Health Ministry data updated on Saturday. The death toll climbed to 3,85,137 with 1,647 fresh fatalities, and active cases comprise 2.55% of the total infections, while the national COVID recovery rate has improved to 96.16%. A total of 19,02,009 tests were conducted on Friday, taking the total cumulative tests conducted so far for detection of COVID in the country to 38,92,07,637, etc. 23% decline in road fatalities in Himachal Pradesh. A decline of 23% has been registered in the number of deaths and 36% in those injured in road accident in the last 1 year in the state. This was stated by Director General of Police DGP Sanjay Kundu while addressing media persons at Nahan. Sanjay Kundu came on a 3-day visit to Sirmaur district. He appealed to officials of all departments to work in unison to put an end to organized crime in the state. The state police have taken stringent measures to curb drug trade, and intoxicants have been seized in large quantities. While investigating such cases, properties of accused worth ₹11.37 crore has been attached. PWD under lens over poor road quality in Palampur. The Public Works Department PWD is under scanner over the damage caused to roads constructed just a few months ago. Heavy rainfall in the last few days has led to the situation, which shows that the PWD has failed to follow the guidelines of the state government to maintain quality in road construction. A number of roads constructed a few months ago in different divisions of PWD in Palampur have washed away in first showers of monsoons. Even the cemented roads built under new technology have failed to wear the load of mini trucks, tempos, and have developed cracks. Most of the roads have been constructed under the centrally sponsored road projects like Pradhan Mantri Gramin Sarak Yojana, National Agriculture Bank for Rural Development NABARD, and Central Road Fund CRF. Interestingly, as per clause of award letters, the contractor are bound to maintain these roads and keep it in a good working condition for 3 to 5 years. However, these roads could not survive even for 6 months. Landslide disrupt traffic near Solan in Himachal Pradesh. Vehicular traffic on the Solan-Shimla section of National Highway 5 was disrupted for about half an hour this morning near Cotton as mounds of debris rolled down on the road from the hill above. Such disruptions have become routine as excavation of the hill due to the four-laning works leads to debris flowing onto the highway. SDM Solan Ajay Yadav and additional SP Ramesh Sharma, who rushed to the spot, instructed the staff of private company four-laning the highway to clear the debris at the earliest. No power supply, oxygen plant non-functional in Palampur. Despite instruction from the Prime Minister's office for speedy installation of medical oxygen plants, the state government has not provided a power connection to a plant in the civil hospital Palampur set up under the PM CARES Fund. As per a central government's letter to state governments, it was their responsibility to provide space and infrastructure to the plants. Though the oxygen plant was ready more than 20 days ago, the power connection has not been provided due to official red tape. The center assigned the task to the DRDO to install plants in Civil Hospital Palampur in May and directed the project manager NHAI to undertake the construction of the structure which had been completed. Four line at Chennai's Aragnar Anna Zoological Park found infected with Delta variant of COVID. The genome sequencing analysis of four samples taken from lines at the Aragnar Anna Zoological Park in Vandalur revealed that they were all affected by the Delta B.1.617.2 variant of COVID. Genome sequencing of four of the samples was done at NIHSCD Bhopal. Analysis of the sequences shows that all the four sequences belong to pangolin lineage B.1.617.2 and are Delta variant as per WHO nomenclature, an official from the release Aragnar Anna Zoological Park read. Assam rocked by 4.2 magnitude earthquake, fifth tremor to hit region in 24 hours. A 4.2 magnitude earthquake struck Assam in the early hours of Saturday, the fifth such tremor to hit the northeastern region during the past 24 hours, officials said. A National Center of Seismology report said the latest quake was recorded at 1.07 am. A National Center of Seismology report said that the latest quake was reported at 1.07 am with its epicenter near Tejpur, the headquarters of Sonitpur district, at a depth of 30 km. There was no immediate report of injury or damage to property. The state was rocked by two more quakes, including a 4.1 magnitude one early on Friday, which also had its epicenter in Sonitpur district. Besides Assam, an earthquake of magnitude 3 with epicenter in Chandel district of Manipur was recorded on Friday, and another 2.6 magnitude tremor with epicenter in West Khasi Hills district of Meghalaya. Milkha Singh's story of struggle and strength will continue to inspire generations, said President Ramnath Kovind. Other leaders also condoled death of Flying Sikh. Legendary Indian sprinter Milkha Singh passed away aged 91 on Friday due to post-COVID complication. As per the PGIM near Chandigarh, the Flying Sikh left for his heavily abode at 11:30 p.m. Following his death, tributes have been pouring in from all sections of society, with President Ramnath Kovind saying that the passing of the sporting icon fills his heart with grief. The story of his struggles and strength of character will continue to inspire generations of Indians. My deepest condolences to his family members and countless admirers, the president tweeted. Prime Minister Narendra Modi said that in the passing away of Milkha Singh, the nation has lost a colossal sportsman. He also expressed that Singh had captured the nation's imagination and had a special place in the hearts of countless Indians. His inspiring personality endeared himself to millions, anguished by his passing away, Prime Minister Narendra Modi said in a tweet. Union Home Minister Amit Shah said that Milkha Singh has left an indelible mark on world athletics. Nation will always remember him as one of the brightest stars of Indian sports, said Shah. Centre likely to hold talks with Jammu and Kashmir parties on June 24. The centre is likely to hold a meeting with all regional parties in Jammu and Kashmir on June 24 as part of its initiative to bolster political processes, including holding assembly elections in the Union Territory, officials said on Friday. The meeting is likely to be chaired by Prime Minister Narendra Modi and attended by Union Home Minister Amit Shah and other central leaders. Mehbooba told on Friday night that she had received a call from the centre for a meeting on June 24. "I am yet to take a decision. I will discuss with my party members and take a final call," she said. Congress seeks white paper as Swiss deposit touch 13-year high. Funds parked by Indian individuals and firms in Swiss banks rose by 183% to over ₹20,700 crore in 2020 as compared to 2019, reported Switzerland's central bank. The huge jump as compared to ₹6,625 crore in Swiss banks at the end of 2019 triggered a demand from the Congress for a white paper from the government. Party's chief spokesperson Randeep Surjewala posted on Twitter an old video of Prime Minister Narendra Modi assuring actions to retrieve black money. Deposits had crossed rupees 52,500 crore in 2006 and has subsequently declined except for a few years in 2011, 13 and 17, according to the Swiss National Bank data. So this is all for this time. Stay connected and keep watching Hillcrest News Channel. Thank you.